you, Faye.
Good evening. You're watching live with Faye on YouTube. Thank you for joining us. That was a different voice you heard. It's because Ira is producing the show today instead of Arun, who needed to travel. We hope he comes back soon. But in the meantime, we're still here every evening to bring you a conversation about what's important in the country. Today, we're going to talk about fuel prices. Now, petrol is at 88 rupees, a little over 88 rupees in Mumbai. It's about 80 rupees in Delhi. We'll put up some numbers on your screen. This is happening largely because the prices have gone up 9 out of 10 days consecutively in the last 10 days. Now, the international market has seen a bit of a rise in early last week. Since then, it's stabled out. There's a storm over the Gulf Coast, and that's caused production to cease. But while, oil marketing companies, state-owned oil marketing companies have decided to increase the price of petrol, they haven't increased the price of diesel. But I'll get to diesel in a second. I also must point out to you the reason why this is worrying is for a couple of reasons. One is more than half what we pay for petrol and diesel is actually just tax. India pays the highest tax on fuel in the world. Diesel prices, let's take a look at diesel prices in a slightly wider window, right? So from mid-March when the lockdown began, diesel was at 65 rupees per litre. It is now at 80 rupees a litre. It's a 15 rupee hike through the lockdown. And that's just taxes. Now, the reason why I worry about diesel prices not having come down at all is because diesel, like I keep telling you, is the fuel that is used to move food and milk and other essentials into our cities and our villages, which means that everything you feed your children, everything you buy, the price will go up with the price of diesel. Now, this is what we're looking at. Petrol in the city of Delhi, that's currently at 80 rupees, 57 paise. The base price and the freight you will see, actually, when it hits the dealer, it's at 25 rupees. After that, excise duty, which is government, central government tax, is 32 rupees, which is higher than the actual price of the tail. The dealer commission on an average is 3.5 rupees, and VAT, which is the state government tax, at 18.5 rupees, bringing the whole thing up to 80 rupees. Remember, you're buying fuel worth 25 rupees for a total of 80 rupees. It's daylight robbery. And especially at a time like this, when the market is as weak as, when the economy is as weak as it is, when so many people are currently struggling to put food on the table, when we already have a problem with inflation, and I'll show you the inflation numbers as well. They're shocking. And this is probably one of the things that has led to that inflation. Retail inflation was actually 6.93% in July. Food went up 10%. Now, who's going to be able to afford this when everybody's losing their jobs? That's the question to ask of why it is that the government cannot find it in their hearts to cut those taxes that they're charging on fuel and provide some relief to the poor in India. An interesting piece of information, of course, is that Sri Lanka actually imports petrol from India after we have refined it. Sri Lanka is selling that petrol to its citizens at 52 rupees, equivalent to 52 Indian rupees. We are selling it at 88 rupees. So that shows you how much of a margin really the Sri Lankan government is taking and how much of a margin the Indian government is taking. And the question that we're asking today is this fair? And should the government be reconsidering? And why hasn't the government reconsidered these taxes? To help us answer these questions today, we have Ali Daruwala, spokesperson of the Petrol Dealers Association. Suresh Khosla is with the Bombay Motor Transport Operators, representing the truck owners who really have the pulse of what's going on in this market. Rajiv Mishra is an RTI activist. We'll have Shaina NC of the BJP join us in a bit. But Santosh Mehrotra joins us. He's an economist, recently retired from JNU. So now he's actually an economist who's consulting both internationally and in India. And I'm very pleased to have him in this conversation as well. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us while we wait for Rajiv Mishra and Shaina NC to join. Let me get opening statements from all of our panelists. Mr. Khosla, if I would start with you. The last time I spoke to a representative of your association, he said that if the prices don't come down, several small truck operators would actually have to shut shop and sell their trucks. Is that still the situation according to you?
Good evening to all. Thanks for inviting me
Faye, for this evening. As you rightly said, today 85% of the trucking population comprises of small operators. So small operators means they are having the fleet of 1 to 5 vehicles. If you see the scene today, it is really very, very bad. We are passing through very rough and tough times today. If, as you rightly said, in the month of March, that is prior to lockdown, 16th March, the diesel rate was 65 rupees. And if we see on 1st August, the diesel price is 80 rupees. And today also, from past 24 days, the diesel price haven't increased. But if you see, there has been an increase of 23% from March till August, which is approximately 15 rupees has increased. So where are we going to survive? Today, there are n number of problems. If you see, a transporter is literally crying. Financial, there is financial pain, and there are a lot of harassment on the roads. There is a lot of harassment by the RTO, by the police, and diesel contributes 70% of our operational cost. So it is a very major component for our survival. And we have been demanding, we have been representing to the government time and again. We want uniform rates. There has to be a uniform rates all over India. Secondly, we have been pleading them, requesting for a monthly or a quarterly revision, which can be better for our calculation. Third, we have been requesting them a very important factor, that the diesel should be under the GST regime. Because rightly you said, we are contributing in per liter, it is 70% component. 70% we are paying through taxes to the central government in the form of excise and state government in the form of VAT, where the basic price is 25 rupees. Today, the diesel is 80 rupees. So 70% is in the form of taxes. So we have to think upon it. Otherwise, survival, as you rightly said, for the small operators or for the big transporters, it is going to be a big issue. And transporters are considered to be the backbone of the economy. If the same scene continues, we are going to face very, very, very tough times.
Mr. Khosla, you know, initially I understand during the lockdown, you would have struggled because there was nothing moving in the country. But now, from what I understand, most of the country has opened up, shops have opened up, markets have opened up. So what is the challenge now for you?
See, rightly speaking, whatever has been opened or whatever was moving during the lockdown period, it was all essential commodities. Today also, the industries are closed. Our movement, there is no industries which has opened up. It is vehicles at the loading locations are getting detained for 3 to 4 days. And once the vehicle comes to the loaded vehicles come at the unloading location, there is another delay of 2 to 3 days because there is shortage of laborers.
Okay. Let me bring in Santosh Mehrotra. Here's the question. Bharat Rawal is asking, is this the government's way of refilling their coffers? Question number one, is this the only possible way in which they can do this? And do you see the 10% food inflation that we saw in the month of July as a direct result of the diesel price increase?
It's an indirect effect. Absolutely. The food inflation is partly definitely being accounted for by this. There are other reasons, like the supply chain has broken down. And because the supply chain has broken down, that's the additional reason for food inflation. But the point is that food inflation is going to and is already feeding into overall inflation, which is already showing up. And if it was not showing up, if it had not been showing up, the RBI about a week ago would have actually cut rates. It didn't cut rates. Why? And it said, the reason why it said that it didn't cut rates is because they were seeing inflation going up. So, you know, this is a catastrophe. This kind of decision making is symptomatic of the poor quality of economic management that we have seen for the last 5 years. If you want, I can give you plenty of evidence of this. I can walk you through that, but I can come back on this. That was not your question. At this time, you should be reducing costs, especially when international oil prices are as low as they are. you should be reducing. Put money into people's hands, not take money out of people's pockets.
Professor, I'm going to still call you that now, force of habit. But the government would argue that at a time like this, when tax collection is really low in terms of income tax and corporate tax, how else is it going to run the country if it doesn't collect tax one way or the other? This is a really easy way to do it. What would be your response to that?
My response to that would be threefold. So thank you for asking that question. First of all, let us recall that pre-pandemic, let us not blame the state of the economy on the pandemic. Pre-pandemic, the economy had been slowing down for 9 quarters successively. With every quarter, sequentially, the growth rate of the economy had been coming down. And why? The process began with the demonetization, which is about the most foolhardy decision that any government would have taken anywhere in the world, but this government took it. And demonetization knocked the bottom out of the unorganized sector, knocked the bottom out of demand in the economy. And if that was not enough, just 6 months later, just 6 months after the demonetization ended, you had a poorly designed, badly planned, and badly implemented GST, a fine tax. The country had been waiting for a GST for a long time. We were hoping that in 2 years' time, it's already 2 years since the GST was announced, 3 years since the GST was announced, we've not seen an increase in tax revenues. GST is supposed to, everywhere else in the world, lead to a buoyancy in tax revenues. In 2 years, when the system stabilizes, you expect increases in tax revenues. And 1 year has passed since 2 years have elapsed, and I'm saying that didn't happen. So first of all, poor economic management, as though that was not bad enough. At the beginning of last year, just before the elections, who asked the government to cut personal income tax? The threshold for personal income tax was suddenly raised from 2.5 lakhs per annum to 5 lakhs per annum. In other words, if there were 60 million personal income taxpayers, as it is, the Prime Minister never fails to remind us that we have too few taxpayers. Okay, but what did the government do just before the elections? It raised the threshold, thereby knocking out 45 million people who were personal income taxpayers from 60 million in January of 2020, when after the threshold was raised, the personal income taxpayer number fell to 15 million. A 45 million decline. Second point. Third point. In July of 2019, corporate tax rates, which were suddenly reduced from 30% to 25%. This same government had 5 years earlier in the budget of 2015, I was live on television and I had distinct memory of the finance minister Arun Jaitley telling the country that we will reduce the corporate tax rate from 2015 onwards over the next 5 years, 1 percentage point every year, and we will eliminate exemptions. The government did not reduce the corporate tax rate for 5 years. However, it reduces the corporate tax rate precisely at a time when its revenues were collapsing, when the economy was slowing, it had just cut personal income taxes. It now reduces corporate income tax, thinking that suddenly private investment is going to revive. It didn't. Of course it didn't. No one expected private investment. So who is responsible? Mm-hmm. Who is responsible for this fiscal crisis? Everyone knows who's responsible for this fiscal crisis, which is the reason why an indirect tax of excise duties on petrol and diesel has been systematically raised, which is eating into the pockets of ordinary people. And this is going to rebound on the government. It is unfortunate, but it is already hurting the people. Don't people know this?
Well, that's a good question. Don't people know this? I just want to check. We lost one of our guests to bad internet. We're trying to get him back. So Ali Daruwala will come back in a bit. Rajiv Mishra is with us. He's an RTI activist. He really is a voice that represents the average Indian citizen. Just to point out to our audience who are thinking that, you know what, I don't have to go to office, so I actually haven't tanked up my car in a while, so I haven't really, you know, the petrol price doesn't really bother me. Everything you buy, whether it's milk or vegetable or fruit or dal, chawal, whatever it is, the price has gone up because of the price of diesel. So it does affect you if you're sitting at home. You know, every little packet of biscuits you have bought has been impacted by this price rise. Rajiv Mishra ji, Professor Mehrotra ka sawal tha ki kya logon ko malum nahi hai ki ye kyun ho raha hai? Aapki kya?
मैं तो सबसे पहले एक बार फिर से आपको धन्यवाद देता हूं कि आप पिछले कई सालों से मैं देख रहा हूं कि आप इन सब इश्यूज पे बहुत ही सिंसियरली जिसको बोलते हैं आप आवाज उठाती हैं, लेकिन मुझे दुर्भाग्य लगता है इस देश के लोगों से। मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इस देश के लोगों को अब ना, मुझे माफ कीजिएगा फिर मैं आपके चैनल पे इस तरह की बात कर रहा हूं, कि ऐसा लगता है कि हम लोग गधे बन चुके हैं। हमारे ऊपर बोझ पे बोझ डालते चले जाओ, हम सहने को तैयार बैठे हैं। आज ये स्थिति पूरे भारतवर्ष की हो गई है। वरना फिर आप हमको बताओ कि आज के समय में ज्यादातर पेट्रोल का यूज अगर आप देखो, ठीक है फोर व्हीलर्स में डीजल का भी स्कोप है और सीएनजी का भी स्कोप है, मगर जो टू व्हीलर्स है वो तो सिर्फ पेट्रोल पे चलते हैं और वो कंप्लीट मिडिल क्लास आदमी की जान है, वो उसी की बदौलत अपने सारी चीजों को पूरा करते हैं। आप मेरे को बताओ, अगर आप सिर्फ पेट्रोल पे, एक लीटर पेट्रोल पे 55 से 60 रुपए केवल आप टैक्स कलेक्शन कर रहे हो, तो एक मिडिल क्लास आदमी जो हर दिन एक लीटर पेट्रोल भरा करके चारों तरफ घूम के अपना रोजगार ढूंढ के 20,000 रुपया महीना कमाता है, वो आपको 60 रुपए के हिसाब से 1800 रुपया पर मंथ वो आपको केवल टैक्स पे कर रहा है पेट्रोल पे। अब आप सोचो कि जो आदमी 20-25,000 रुपया कमाता है वो 1800 रुपया उसका आप पेट्रोल से टैक्स ले रहे हो, यार कितनी बुरी स्थिति लोगों को गुजरनी पड़ रही है। लेकिन मैं आपको एक बात बता दूं, इन सब चीजों से आज हमको लगता है कि इतना ज्यादा डिबेट हम लोग इस पर कर चुके हैं, लेकिन आप देखो गवर्नमेंट हिलने को तैयार नहीं और लोग जगने को तैयार नहीं।
मिश्रा जी, एक और आपकी बात पे एक और मुझे एक बात जोड़नी है कि अभी जो हम लोग घर पे बैठे हैं, हम वर्क फ्रॉम होम कर रहे हैं, हम घर पे बैठे हैं, तो सारी चीजें हम ऑर्डर करते हैं, कोई बेचारा आके डिलीवरी करता है, वो तो टू व्हीलर पे ही डिलीवरी करेगा ना, तो उनका मार्जिन जो अब सबसे ज्यादा काम कर रहे हैं जो डिलीवरी वाले, उनके मार्जिन पे क्या असर होगी अगर पेट्रोल के प्राइस ऐसे बढ़ाते ही जाएंगे सरकार? तो
मैं तो एक बात बताऊं, अगर आप रियल बोलो ना, तो लॉकडाउन का पीरियड है या पिछले कुछ दिनों से जो आप देख रही है कि इकोनॉमिकल क्राइसिस जो चल रहा है, उसमें सबसे ज्यादा शिकार अगर कोई हो रहा है तो मिडिल क्लास और लोअर मिडिल क्लास। आपको मैं बता दूं, गरीबों के लिए तो शायद लोग बोल देते हैं कि 5 किलो अनाज मैंने दे दिया, लेकिन ये मिडिल क्लास और लोअर मिडिल क्लास तो इस अनाज से भी वंचित है, क्योंकि इनके पास वो राशन कार्ड नहीं है जिस पर वो जाकर के उसको अवेल कर सकते हैं। आप समझ के रखो, फिर आपको मैं बताऊं, मैंने पहले भी आपको एक बार बताया था कि जो स्थिति अभी चल रही है ये आगे चल के इतनी भयानक होने वाली है कि बहुत सारे जिन लोगों को अपने ईगो से कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं कर पाते हैं, जो अपने स्वाभिमान से कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं कर पाते हैं, उनका परिवार अब सुसाइडल की ओर बढ़ रहा है। फिर आपको दिखाई दे रहा है कि नहीं मुझे मालूम नहीं, लेकिन मैं जिस जगह पे रहता हूँ यहाँ बहुत सारे केसेस ऐसे आ रहे हैं जो इकोनॉमिकल क्राइसिस के कारण परिवार के साथ लोग सुसाइड कर रहे हैं, परिवार के साथ। अभी मेरे को बताओ फिर, अगर इतने के बाद भी अगर सरकार की आंख नहीं खुल रही है और हम इतना झेलने के बाद भी जग नहीं रहे, तो हमको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि आखिर ये कौन सा बंधन है जो हमें जगने नहीं दे रहा है, और सरकार कौन से बंधन में बंधी है जो आंख खोलने को तैयार नहीं है। मुझे ये बात आज तक समझ में नहीं आया। और जो प्रोफेसर साहब ने कहा कि लोगों को क्या मालूम नहीं, अरे लोग तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है फिर कि ये पहली बार है जब हम मानसिक रूप से गुलाम हो चुके हैं। जो हम आजादी के पहले जो गुलामी की मानसिकता में जी रहे थे, वो गुलामी की मानसिकता आज हमारे अंदर आ गई है। हम आज जिसको आज हम लोग बोलते हैं कि फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच है हमारे पास, लेकिन मैंने कहीं नहीं देखा कि लोग उसका इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं। आज लोग ऐसा दबे कुचले महसूस कर रहे हैं कि उनके पास आंदोलन करने के लिए भी जान नहीं है। तो मुझे तो ऐसा लगता है कि ये बहुत ही सिस्टमैटिक लोगों को कमजोर किया जा रहा है, लोगों की आवाज को भी बहुत ही सिस्टमैटिक दबाया जा रहा है, कि पहले आपके पेट में अनाज होगा तब जाके आप आवाज कर पाओगे ना, हम आपको इतना मजबूर कर देंगे कि जो वो 2,000-5,000 देंगे आपको उसी में संतुष्ट रहना है।
मिश्रा जी सरकार ने तो राशन कार्ड पे फ्री में अनाज दिया है, दाल दिया हुआ है, तेल दिया हुआ है, तो इससे आपको नहीं लगता कि फर्क होने वाली?
यही मैं आपको बताना चाह रहा हूँ। आप देखो, सरकार जो राशन कार्ड पे दे रही है वो जो इकोनॉमिकल पुअर सेक्शन वाले लोग हैं उनके लिए है। आप ऑरेंज कार्ड तक, उन्होंने बोला कि ऑरेंज कार्ड पर जो रहेगा वो हम देंगे। अब हम लोग जैसे लोगों की बात कर लो, हम लोगों का ऑरेंज कार्ड डिक्लाइन हो चुका है, हम लोग ऑरेंज कार्ड में आते नहीं है। हम लोगों का चूंकि इनकम टैक्स भरते हैं तो हम लोग 3,00,000-4,00,000 का इनकम टैक्स भरते हैं, तो हमको ऑरेंज कार्ड से बाहर कर दिया गया। अब ऐसी स्थिति में आज जिन लोगों के व्यवसाय पर असर पड़ा है, जिनके रोजगार पर असर पड़ा है, वहां आप मदद करने की बजाय अगर आप पेट्रोल और डीजल और सीएनजी की दामों को बढ़ा कर करके अगर आप उनके पॉकेट में सेंधमारी कर रहे हो, चोरी कर रहे हो उनके पॉकेट की, तो ये तो मतलब मैं तो कहता हूं कि ये पीड़ित व्यक्ति को आप और मतलब जिसको बोलते हैं ना जले पे नमक छिड़कना, आप जले पे नमक छिड़क रहे हो, आप एक घायल व्यक्ति को और घायल कर रहे हो। ये तो मुझे समझ में नहीं आता कि सरकार किस नीति पे चल रही है। और मैं बहुत दुर्भाग्य से कहता हूं इस बात को लेकर के कि आप जैसे एंकर, आप जैसे पत्रकारों के रहने के बावजूद इस देश की जनता में कोई जागरण नहीं आ रहा। ये मेरे लिए बहुत अफसोस का बात है और मैं इस बात से बहुत चिंतित हूं कि आखिर लोगों को क्या हो गया है, क्यों इतने मानसिक रूप से लोग गुलाम हो चुके हैं, क्यों उनकी सहनशीलता इतनी बढ़ गई है कि उनके ऊपर सारे जुल्म किए जा रहे हैं फिर भी वो शांत और खामोश है। अब ये मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा।
पॉइंट ये बात मैं शाइना एनसी के पास लेके जा रही हूँ, वो बीजेपी के, भाजपा के हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए हैं अभी। शाइना जी नमस्कार, थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस। राजीव मिश्रा जी का ये कहना है कि मिडिल क्लास पे जो बोझ, गवर्नमेंट जो बोझ लगाए जा रही है, पेट्रोल प्राइसेस, फूड प्राइसेस, जॉब लॉस, और गवर्नमेंट सुन ही नहीं रही है किसी की बात। पेट्रोल प्राइस को लेके, डीजल प्राइस को लेके आपके क्या जवाब है, सरकार की क्या जवाब है कि प्राइसेस और टैक्स को क्यों नहीं काटा जा रहा?
हेलो,
शाइना जी, आपका आपको अपने को अनम्यूट कर लीजिए, अनम्यूट कर लीजिए जी।
I did unmute.
Yes, yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, you can hear you.
I did unmute.
Yes, Shaina, my question to you was this. Why do you think that the government is not reducing taxes on fuel? Because that burden falls directly on the middle class that's already losing jobs. We come back to
China
and see. Ali
Daruwala,
go ahead.
Yeah. Free, I've got one question to ask over here. Since you mentioned about taxes, I'd like to bring to your notice, there's a 3 rupee tax in Maharashtra, which was levied in last 1.5-2 months. That was called the COVID cess. 2 rupees, first they levied on the 9th of April, 1 rupee. And later during May, they levied another 2 rupees, 3 rupees COVID tax. But let me make it very clear, before levying these 3 rupee taxes, we were already paying 2 rupees as drought cess. Drought has gone. We had floods last year at same time. That cess has not gone. Another 3 rupees. That means in Maharashtra, people should know that 5 rupees is just cess that we are paying over and above the taxes, VAT and excise. So can't the Maharashtra government, if they feel they're sensitive, can withdraw this cess with immediate effect? At least to bring the price down, like how Delhi government did it.
That's a fair question. In fact, I must tell our audience in full disclosure, Mr. Daruwala is the head of the Petrol Dealers Association. He is also, while he's a spokesperson of the Petrol Dealers Association, he's also affiliated to the RSS, and this is a disclosure that must come to you. My point here, Mr. Daruwala, is about taxes altogether, state and center. They should all be rationalized. And, while each state right now is looking to compensate for the lack of their GST collection and the transfers coming in from the central government, why doesn't the central government take a lead? Don't you believe the central government should take a lead?
Yeah, the prices, the excise is correlated to the market. When the prices were falling, the excise was covering it up. Now, as the prices are going up, excise is at the same time coming down. This should be brought to the notice of the people. The shortfall that happened when it reached $25-$30 in the beginning of April, that time the excise was absorbed, the price fall was absorbed and the rates were increased. But subsequently, when the rates are going up now, excises are coming down. See,
well, can you give me a date when the excise duty was coming down? When has the excise duty been cut?
Twice. They, just two times they raised the excise to take absorb the reduction into the government kitty. That is what had happened last. But now it is frozen. And as it goes...
No, you just said, Mr. Ali Daruwala, you just said that the excise has been coming down. When has it come down?
No, it has not come down, but they have not increased. They have not increased the excise in the last two months. Yeah.
So you see it as a good thing that the excise has not increased?
It's not increased in the last 2 months. Excise has not increased because there has not been a reduction in the price.
Anyone on the panel who wants to rebut that? Rajiv Mishraji, go ahead.
See, now you can see Daru wala jo bol rahe hain. Agar ye petrol dealer association kehte hain, isse zyada kaun janta hai? आप मेरे को एक बार बताओ एक्साइज ड्यूटी 2014 में क्या था और आज क्या है. आप ये कह करके तर्क नहीं दे सकते कि अगर कच्चे तेल की कीमत कम हो रही है तो एक्साइज ड्यूटी बढ़ जाता है और कच्चे तेल की कीमत ज्यादा हो रही है तो एक्साइज ड्यूटी कम हो जाता है. ये कोई तर्क है फिर? आप हमको बताओ 24 रुपए 25 रुपए के पेट्रोल पर आप 32 रुपए सेंट्रल एक्साइज ड्यूटी कलेक्ट कर रहे हो और आप कह रहे हो कि आप बढ़ा नहीं रहे हो. और यही इसके पहले 7.5 रुपए थे और उसको बढ़ा करके आपने 32 रुपए कर दिया और आप बोल रहे हो कि आप बढ़ा नहीं रहे. तो हमको लगता है कि दारू वाला जो है वो निश्चित तौर पे भले उनको सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट से ऐसा कौन सा गिफ्ट मिल रहा है मुझे मालूम नहीं, लेकिन मुझे ये समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि इस तरह की बात वो कैसे कह सकते हैं. उनको ये समझना चाहिए कि चाहे पेट्रोल हो या डीजल हो, आज आप देखो डीजल जो मोस्ट इसेंशियल सर्विस का एक पार्ट है, आज आप समझ के रखो डीजल को आपने 80 रुपए पहुंचा दिया. जो डीजल और पेट्रोल की कीमतों में हमेशा कम से कम 15-20 रुपए का अंतर होता था, उसको आपने क्लोज एकदम सटा दिया पेट्रोल के प्राइस से. और तो भी आपको मतलब कैसे आप डिफेंड कर रहे हो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट को, इट इज वेरी सरप्राइजिंग. और मैं बोलता हूँ चाहे वो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हो या स्टेट गवर्नमेंट हो, दोनों का ये फर्ज है कि भाई इसका जो अंजाम है वो हम जैसे सामान्य लोग भुगत रहे हैं उनको किसी भी तरीके से राहत दिए जाने की जरूरत है. और ऐसा कोई नहीं कर सकता कि स्टेट गवर्नमेंट अपना रेवेन्यू लॉस करे और सेंट्रल मजा मारे, सेंट्रल अपना रेवेन्यू लॉस करे स्टेट मजा मारे. इसलिए ये दोनों को कंबाइन बैठ करके ये निर्णय लेना चाहिए कि मैं 5 रुपया छोड़ता हूँ, आप भी 5 रुपया छोड़ो और 10 रुपए का एक रिडक्शन हम लोग जनरल पब्लिक को देते हैं. ये एक तरीका है. पे हमारा कहना नहीं कि सरकार तो दोनों ही है, हमने तो दोनों को मत दिया, लोकसभा में उनको मत दिया, विधानसभा में इनको मत दिया, ये कह करके तो आप नहीं कह सकते ना. आज आप मैं तो सरप्राइज हूं कि लोग गवर्नमेंट के साथ क्यों खड़े हो रहे हैं. अरे भाई मर आदमी रहा है, आम आदमी को सताया जा रहा है, आप गवर्नमेंट के साथ क्यों खड़ा होना चाहते हो? अगर आप भी आम आदमी हो, अगर आप भी लोगों के बारे में चिंतित हो तो आप भी आवाज उठाओ ना. गवर्नमेंट है तो है, जिसने वोट दिया हमने चुना ठीक है, लेकिन अब तो मेरा एक्सपेक्टेशन ये है कि मैंने चुना था अपनी अच्छाई के लिए.
So let me bring in Suresh Khosla as well of the motor transport operators. Mr. Khosla, do you agree with Ali Daruwala that yes, it's a good thing that it has not come down and that's something we should be grateful for?
No. See, whatever Mr. Ali Wala has said, I don't agree with him. See, what he said that the excise duty has come down. See, whatever has come down or gone up, the effect should be seen at the end of the day. Where is the effect? आप जैसे बताया अली जी ने कि एक्साइज ड्यूटी दो बार कम हुई है तो आप इफेक्ट तो बताइए. आज एक गाड़ी वाला एक ट्रांसपोर्टर बेचारा अपना एसेट लेके ही इज लिटरली क्राइंग, वो मर रहा है. देयर इज नो वे, उसको सुइसाइड करना है, बस एक ही इलाज है आज की तारीख में. आज 80 रुपीज का डीजल है और मार्च से लेके अपना 23% अपना डीजल बढ़ गया है. हमारे भाड़े बढ़े हैं? बिल्कुल नहीं भाड़े बढ़े. अगर हम भाड़े बढ़ाएंगे तो अल्टीमेटली वो पास ऑन किसके पास जाता है? एंड यूजर के पास जाएगा. गाड़ी वाला क्या करेगा? देयर इज फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस, देयर हैज टू बी अ वे आउट. वी हैव बीन रिप्रेजेंटिंग टू द गवर्नमेंट टाइम एंड अगेन, आप इसको जीएसटी के रेजिम में क्यों नहीं लेके आते हैं? The maximum limit is 28% in GST, whereas we are paying 70% in the form of taxes. What the government has problem? जैसे अपना मिश्रा जी ने बताया है कि सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट अपना मिलके अपना there has to be consensus and there has to be a way out for every solution there for every problem there is a solution. या तो government करना नहीं चाहती है या क्या करना चाहती है? हम तो बेचारे transporter हैं, हम तो अपना representing कर सकते हैं.
Let me also bring in Professor Santosh Mehrotra. There's another impact here on farmers, because effectively, even if a farmer grows 10 kgs of onions, and they grow a lot more than that, they have to put it on the back of a truck that runs on diesel and take it to the nearest market. And that adds to the price of food and takes out of the margin of the farmer as well. Professor Mehrotra, go ahead.
No, you're absolutely right. So I won't come back to the food inflation. You've already pointed that out. I want to make three other points. In response to, with all due respect to Darwala sir. First of all, I have deep sympathy what Suresh Khosla was saying earlier about the implications of this increasing prices all the time on small truck operators who are 1 to 5, you know, who have 1 to 5 vehicles. That means that they are going to increasingly close down. We already have general survey information about small and medium enterprises suffering very deeply post lockdown. I'm not talking about the lockdown. So on the one hand, we want to support MSMEs because the MSMEs are the one which create the job. Let's just recall that transport is the biggest job creator in the services sector. Most people don't know this. It's the biggest job creator in the services sector, point one. Point two, let's just remember that because of the mismanagement of the economy and the economy was slowing down, the government, central government has not passed on the dues to the state governments, which they were due. That means the GST revenues that should have gone automatically, the central government has not passed on. So
professor sir, forgive me, agar aap ye cheez hindi mein batayenge to zyada logon ko
main bahut aasani se bahut aasani se hindi mein bata sakta hu. Dekhiye, yaad rakhiye ki kendra sarkar ka GST ke antargat ye rule hai ki jo revenues collect hoti hain wo state ki jo bhagidari hoti hai wo state ke paas jani aavashyak hai. वो लीगली रिक्वायर्ड है, जीएसटी के मुताबिक रिक्वायर्ड है, और केंद्र सरकार नहीं दे रही है. तो अगर केंद्र सरकार इतनी कंगाली की स्थिति में है कि वो ये कह रहे कि हम तुम्हें जो ड्यू है वो देंगे नहीं, तो राज्य सरकार क्या करेगी? वो सेस बढ़ाएगी कि नहीं बढ़ाएगी? दूसरी बात, तीसरी बात, अगर 32 रुपए, मेरी आखिरी बात कह लू मैं, उसके बाद आखिरी बात टैक्सेस में, अब फिर तुमने शुरू में बताया कि एक्साइज ड्यूटी 32 रुपए है, और यानी कि सेंट्रल एक्साइज ड्यूटी 32 रुपए है, और स्टेट टैक्सेस 20 और 25 रुपए के बीच में है. तो यानी कि द शेयर ऑफ टोटल टैक्सेस दैट यू एंड आई आर पेइंग व्हिच इज गोइंग टू द स्टेट्स ऑन पेट्रोल डीजल इज लोअर. तो जिम्मेदारी किसकी ज्यादा बनती है? केंद्र सरकार की बनती है कि नहीं? तो तीन आपको मैंने कारण बता दिए कि केंद्र सरकार की जिम्मेदारी बनती है, क्योंकि ये एक तरीका है वैसे जेब में डालने का, क्योंकि वरना डिमांड नहीं बढ़ेगी. ये बड़ी साधारण बात है वे कि मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स 101 जो हम अपने 20 साल के बच्चों को पढ़ाते हैं, वो सरकार में कोई नहीं समझता.
अली जी, क्या आपको
We all have lost the main crux as to why the prices of petrol and diesel went up by 10 rupees in last 2 months, 2 to 3 months. It is not the government to be blamed. The main reason the prices went up is on 1st April, Euro 6 petrol and diesel was introduced. And to make our plants efficient for refining this Euro 6 petrol and diesel, 36,000 crores was spent by all the three oil companies. The money which has been spent is being recovered by these three oil companies by increasing 10 rupees on petrol and diesel vice versa. This is the reason the prices have gone up, and the oil company is the main culprit for this prices to go up. No one has ever mentioned about that. It is not reported in any single print or electronic media. Today, let me make it very clear, the central government has got nothing to do with this. It is the oil companies who on their own have increased the prices by 10 rupees on both petrol and diesel. Faye.
These oil companies are owned by whom, Mr. Ali Dhanwala?
Exactly.
Yes, yes.
Exactly.
Yes, yes.
Exactly. Correct.
The revenue, government enterprise.
Are these private
correct,
sector?
Correct. They are not 100%. They are not at all 100%. The government has a stake into them, a small percentage of stake, but the pricing and all was decided by the government. But this 10 rupees was a total and full-fledged oil company decision which was taken.
You are aware of the fact that the oil company takes instructions directly from the Ministry of Petroleum.
But this 10 rupees I'm talking about, forget the larger picture. This 10 rupees that I'm answering.
I'm sorry, I'm not wired to forget the larger picture.
No, but this 10 rupees, the immediate increase.
To forget the larger picture. Picture still shows me
correct,
that the government is still making 70 rupees out of the total. 70% out of the total 88 rupees that I'm paying. So oil marketing companies still have to make themselves viable, I agree, but I don't understand why we're paying this much tax. What? Highest tax in the world. And I find it interesting, true. Mr. Ali Dhanwala, that until last year, you were vehemently against
the tax. No, I'm just talking about this 10 rupees pay. No, Faye, I'm just bringing, yes. Don't form your opinion. About this 10 rupees that we saw in the last 2 months, that is an explanation I'm giving to you, Faye.
Okay.
It has gone up because of the refining cost that we are paying. And no one ever has mentioned this, nor it's been mentioned in any of the electronic and the print media.
Okay,
so we
should
understand.
I'll share an article with you. This is the 5th of May, and I'm reading out of the Hindu,
Hindu was the only paper, but
don't speak over me. Do not speak over me. Not that kind of show. My team will put it up on the screen. This is the Hindu. It's a PTI copy. On the 5th of May, well into the lockdown, the headline says, the government hikes excise duty on petrol by 10 rupees a litre and diesel by 13 rupees a litre. And it says the government on Tuesday evening hiked excise duty by a record 10 rupees a litre on petrol and 13 rupees a litre on diesel to garner a total of 1.6 lakh crore rupees as additional revenue as it repeated its time-tested formula of not passing on gains arising from a slump in international oil prices. So I don't know what you are referring to, Mr. Ali Dhanwala, but technically, according to this article, which is a PTI copy, the hike of 10 rupees a litre on petrol was directly done by the government of India. I'm going to open this again to the rest of my panel, to anyone who wants to respond to that. Rajiv Mishra, go ahead.
See, agar aap dekho jo Dhanwala bol rahe hain, aap khud se dekh lo, aapne aapka jo price list hai, usko aap padh lo. अभी भी जो कच्चे तेल की कीमत है वो 25 रुपए आती है रिफाइन करने के बाद, और आपका जो टैक्स है वो 70 रुपए में ये करीब करीब 60 रुपए के ऊपर जाता है। सारे टैक्सेस अगर आप जोड़ लो, सेस वगैरह सारे वैट वगैरह सब जोड़ लो तो 63 रुपए के आसपास आता है पेट्रोल पे। अब ऐसे में मेरे को बताओ कि जो दारू वाला कह रहे हैं कि 10 रुपए एक्स्ट्रा उनको एक्सपेंसेस करने पड़े हैं, तो वो तो दिखना चाहिए था ना, 35 रुपए दिखना चाहिए था ना। आज 25 रुपए आपके रिफाइन करने के बाद है, बाकी सारे टैक्सेस हैं। ऐसे में आप कैसे इस बात का बचाव कर सकते हो? और दारू वाला भूल रहे हैं,
बचाव नहीं कर रहा हूं मैं आपको समझा रहा हूं।
नहीं नहीं दारू वाला साहब, आप याद करो कि जब $140 प्रति बैरल कच्चे तेल की कीमत थी, तब अगर 70 रुपए हुआ था तो इसी बीजेपी सरकार ने हंगामा, मतलब बीजेपी विरोधी पक्ष में थी, हंगामा मचा दिया था। और आज जब $50 प्रति बैरल जब कच्चे तेल मिल रहे हैं, आप उसको नहीं देखोगे? और उसके बाद अगर 88 रुपए पेट्रोल अगर लोगों को खरीदना पड़ रहा है, क्या इस चीज का गणना आप नहीं करोगे? आप टेक्निकलिटी, आप जो कुछ भी, आप सामान्य आदमी को समझाने जाओ, लोगों को तो ये मालूम है कि कच्चे तेल की कीमत गिरी है, उसके बावजूद उनको 88 रुपए पे करने पड़ रहे हैं। और जब कच्चे तेल की कीमत ज्यादा थी तब वो 70 रुपए 72 रुपए पे करते थे। तो कौन गवर्नमेंट लोगों का जेब काट रही है ये तो बहुत अच्छी तरह समझ सकता है आदमी। मैं माना कि कांग्रेस भी काटती होगी जेब, लेकिन आपने तो उससे 3 कदम आगे जाकर के लोगों का जेब काटना शुरू कर दिया ना। मैं ये कहना चाह रहा हूँ आपको,
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, टैक्स कम होना चाहिए, सेस जाना चाहिए, मैं आपसे बिल्कुल सहमत हूँ, इसके वजह से हम सब में बड़ा जो नुकसान वो पेट्रोल पंप वालों का होता है, ये इंटरस्टेट यहाँ से सस्ता वहां से महंगा, ट्रक्स इधर उधर जाते हैं।
दारू वाला साहब, आम आदमी का, आपका आपका उतना नुकसान नहीं होता, आप लोग मैनेज करना जानते हैं। मरता आम आदमी है जो बाइक पर आपके यहाँ पेट्रोल लेने आता है, आप देख लीजिए 20-20 रुपए का लोगों ने पेट्रोल भराना शुरू कर दिया, ये स्थिति हो गई आम आदमी के, वो एक लीटर नहीं लेता है, आपको बोलता है 20 रुपए का डाल दो, 30 रुपए का डाल दो। ये सीन शायद आप देखते हैं कि नहीं, हम लोग देखते हैं एवरीडे अपने लाइफ में। अब जहां पर लोग 20 रुपए का पेट्रोल आपसे मांग रहे हैं, आप कल्पना कर सकते हैं कि लोगों की स्थिति क्या हो गई है, लोगों की स्थिति क्या, वो एक लीटर नहीं डलवा पा रहे हैं, वो 20 रुपए और 30 रुपए का पेट्रोल डाल करके अपना अर्जेंट वर्क पूरा करते हैं। तो इतने के बाद अगर आप लोग गवर्नमेंट के साथ खड़ा होंगे और गवर्नमेंट को आप लोग पूछेंगे नहीं कि आखिर लोगों ने क्या कसूर किया, आपको पूर्ण बहुमत देकर के कसूर किया, क्या कसूर किया हम लोगों ने, तो बताओ इतना सारा, इतनी ताकत देने के बाद जब हमको ये जुर्म सहना है, तो फिर लोगों का कौन सा कसूर का सजा ये पा रहे हैं हम लोग, इतना नहीं पूछेगा कोई आदमी।
सुरेश खोसला जी से भी पूछना है। सुरेश जी, आपने बताया कि जो एसेट है, जो ट्रक है, जो ट्रक ड्राइवर अपने ट्रक पे ईएमआई भरते हैं, उनको आरबीआई की तरफ से मॉरेटोरियम मिला था कि 3 महीने के लिए आप अपना ईएमआई मत भरो, उससे कोई उनको कुछ सुविधा मिली, उनको कुछ रिलीफ मिली? सुरेश जी,
फिर आई विल जस्ट आंसर दिस, आई जस्ट वांटेड टू टेल अनदर थिंग, मिस्टर अली ही हैड मेंशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द कोविड सेस, राइट। मुझे ये बताना है कि हिंदुस्तान में अगर कोई चीज लागू हो जाती है, वो चीज वापस नहीं होती, वो चीज बढ़ती
रिवर्स नहीं होती है,
वो चीज कभी भी रिवर्स नहीं होती, इट इज नेवर रिवर्स्ड। इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेकन, बिकॉज अली जी तो एक्सपर्ट है, उनके पास तो पूरा कैलकुलेशन होगा, व्हेन द टोल वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, बिकॉज एज अ ट्रांसपोर्टर डीजल इज अ मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट एंड नाउ वी आर सफरिंग विद द टोल टैक्स विच इज अ मेजर कॉम्पोनेंट फॉर अस, विच कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स 20-25% ऑफ अवर ऑपरेशनल कॉस्ट। Whatever diesel per liter or petrol per liter we are paying, in that toll is also included. So this means इधर से भी हम pay कर रहे हैं and on the toll tax also we are paying. ये आम आदमी को नहीं पता है, इधर से तो जा ही रहा
है। और तीसरी बात आपको पुलिस वाले रोकते हैं आपके ट्रक ड्राइवर्स को, उनसे पैसे लेते हैं, अलग बात।
Yes, yes.
उनको उनसे पार्किंग का पैसे लिया जाता है।
This is I will say it is harassment, dadagiri. It is a dadagiri. There is no in all the national highways. It is all what we say. It is all hand to gloves. It is all hand to gloves. Aadmi gaadi chalaye ya inki dadagiri sahan kare. There was an incident in the in Rajasthan at Kishangarh. The RTO, the truck driver had literally hit the van and the police fellow, and he was injured also in that particular case. Now I'll come to your, you had asked me the question, yeah, Faye?
Yes. I had asked you a question about RBI moratorium.
Yeah, see, in the lockdown period, there was no business. All the trucks, all the business was standstill. So the people, since there was no income, so they couldn't pay any EMI. And now since the RBI has given the relief, and now they have given the moratorium, which they have extended, but now also the people, they are having financial crisis because there was no income, there was no running, they are in financial crisis as on date.
Professor ji, agar ye fuel ke price aise hi badhti jayegi ya tax ghataya nahi jayega, to kya asar hone wali hai ek do mahine mein?
Suresh Khosla ji ke jitne कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स हैं, राजीव मिश्रा जी के जितने भागीदारी है जहां पर, गाली दारू वाला जी के, इन सारे बिजनेसेस बंद हो जाने वाले, ये होने वाला।
yes, yes,
नौकरियां
yes.
जाएंगी, जब नौकरियां जाएंगी तो डिमांड और घटेगी, और जब डिमांड और घटेगी तो आप सोच सकते हैं कि भुखमरी शुरू होगी। तब भुखमरी शुरू होने की संभावना आ रही है। अभी मेरी तो आंखें खुल गई राजीव मिश्रा जी की बात सुन करके, लोग 20 रुपए का पेट्रोल भरवा रहे हैं। मैं तो मतलब जीवन में ये कभी कहानी सुनी नहीं मैंने, हमारे देश में ये स्थिति कभी नहीं आई। और मैं आपको फिर कई हफ्तों से कह रहा हूँ कि यू हैव नॉट सीन एनीथिंग येट, जो आप अभी तक देख रहे हैं उससे कहीं ज्यादा बदतर होने वाली है स्थिति, क्योंकि इस साल में ही इकॉनमी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करेगी करीब 15%, और अगले साल आरबीआई स्वयं कह रहा है कि साल के अंत में, अगले साल यानी कि 22 के फाइनेंशियल ईयर में, साल के अंत में शायद रिकवरी शुरू होगी। रिकवरी का मतलब ये नहीं कि ग्रोथ शुरू हो जाएगी, रिकवरी का मतलब ये है कि हम उस ओर अग्रसर होंगे जो स्तर हमारी हमारी आय का था 19-20 में, उस तरफ अग्रसर होंगे, उस स्तर पे नहीं आएंगे। उस स्तर पे आने के लिए शायद हमें 22-23 तक का इंतजार करना पड़ेगा। बहुत जल्दी होगा अगर 22-23 तक हम उस स्तर पे आ पाएंगे जो 19-20 का स्तर था। अब आप सोच लीजिए इस बीच में कितनी नौकरियां और जाएंगी, कितनी गरीबी बढ़ेगी, कितनी वेजेस कम होंगी। आप सोचना मुश्किल हो रहा है। मैं तो ये स्थिति बहुत भयानक और भयावह लग रही है।
अब इसके बाद कोई आगे क्या बोले। अली दारूवाला जी, क्या आपको भी लगता है कि पेट्रोल डीलर्स एसोसिएशन में जितने नौकरियां हैं जो फ्यूल भराते हैं पेट्रोल स्टेशन में, उनकी भी नौकरियों की प्रॉब्लम होगी अभी?
Faith, to be very honest with you, sales have come back to 60-70%. Diesel has not swung into action. Petrol has come to 60-70-80%. Like a city like Pune, I'll tell you, we used to sell 30 lakh liters petrol for the entire city. And now the sale has reached to 25 lakh liters a day. This is the sale I'm talking about. Diesel, we were selling 40 lakh liters a day. Now we have reached 22 lakh liters. Sale has come to 60-70%. Let us not be so negative. Let's be little positive. I think the economy should come back, and it is this business community who will bring the economy back on track, and not like 2 and 3 years, as the gentleman said. I think the businessman will bring the country back on his feet. Industry, at least my industry, I can tell you that it's reached to 70% of what they used to sell in the past.
In the past when?
Before the lockdown, we were selling, like I said, told you, 30 lakh liters. We have come back to 25 to 20 lakh liters per day.
Okay, so you've come back to 20-25 liters per day. I have a quick question for Suresh Khosla. Picking up from what Ali Daruwala has said, he has said that business community will, the business people will come back. Now, the largest number of business people in this country are small and medium enterprises who run workshops in small factories to manufacture small things. Tissue boxes, nuts and bolts for the automobile industry, things like that. All of their raw materials come in on a truck. Their finished product gets delivered on a truck. Un pe kya asar padega, Suresh Khosla ji? Aapke clients honge. Manufacturing industry pe kya asar?
Today, if you see the industry, manufacturing industries, it is not operating in full swing. It is only 10-20%. Because the vehicles are getting, we don't have loads. The vehicles are standing. The vehicles are getting detained. And if the same scene continues, jaise Santosh Mehrotra ji ne bataya hai, poor quality economy management. Very good word, apne bahut achhi tarah se samjha diya hai. Agar yehi chalta raha, to I think so, we have to face very tough times. Jaise ek garib insan ko agar do bolenge, to wo do ka matlab samjhega, do roti. Ali ji, wo roti samjhega. And I have been requesting time and again, we have been demanding to the government, the petrol prices has to be under the GST regime. And if any increase in diesel or petrol, there has to be a monthly or quarterly revision so that we can have the homework at our end and the uniformity of diesel prices.
Well, I find it very interesting to take this back to Santosh Mehrotra ji, that on the one hand, we have the Truck Drivers Association, and just reminding our viewers to use the Super Chat feature to support us financially and also to highlight your questions. Pankaj says, should we start to explore medieval methods like gula carts again? The Conclave says, thank you for what you do. Someone else pointing out that why hasn't the Supreme Court taken cognizance of this when it has taken cognizance of other things? An interesting question. But we have here Suresh ji telling us that factories are not operating. They're only at 10%. That markets are functioning a lot slower. Vegetable markets are functioning a lot slower than they used to. But Mr. Daruwala is telling us that they are back up to 70% sale of fuel. I don't know how these numbers can actually reconcile with each other. Santosh Mehrotra?
No. Look, the lockdown ended. Economic activity began to return. So you know, capacity utilization improved. That's all we are hearing. He's himself saying that it's sort of back to 50%, 60%. I mean, so he's actually confirming what I'm saying, that we have no idea when we might return to levels prevailing in 1920. But let me just try and put a how to use this challenge as an opportunity. This is the time that we should finally, the government should finally say, less private vehicles, more public transport. What does that mean? It means that the government will have to buy buses and put buses on the roads so that the motorcycles and the scooters and the cars don't come back. That means you and I, ordinary people in London, in New York, I've lived in both places. I used to travel by tube and by metro. Why? Everyone in their three-piece suit and their overcoats and hats would go by tube and metro. Why? Because it's the reasonable thing to do. But it has to be available from place to place. Point one. Point two, I think the government has to really come down seriously about bicycles. Bicycle tracks have to be made, bus lanes have to be made, and the price of metro prices have to be reduced. And if you do that, then ridership will increase. Ridership will increase. This is the way forward if we want to use this as an opportunity.
Okay. I'm going to leave it here and wrap it up because we've run out of time. I want to thank my audience, but I just want to point this out. The Mumbai local is not functioning right now, which means that everyone who needs to move around has to use a private vehicle. The Delhi Metro is not functioning right now because of the lockdown. And this is the case with several cities. Even if buses are functioning, they're functioning at half capacity. So on one hand, people are losing jobs. On the other hand, there is no public transport. They have to either get a taxi or they have to take out their own two-wheelers and they have to travel. At this time, to increase fuel, to increase the price of food, to increase the price of fuel, cut into the margin of that Swiggy delivery boy, that person who's bringing you your vegetable to your doorstep because you shouldn't be stepping out of the house ideally, to be able to cut the margin of the person who's driving a taxi on the road, the person who's been driving a truck through the lockdown and delivering our food at a time when we couldn't get it from anywhere else, to actually punish these people. The only ones, I mean, there are this entire group of people who've already lost their jobs, who have not earned during the lockdown. We're now punishing those people who are working, who have found ways to continue to earn, to deliver milk, to deliver food, to deliver vegetables. We're punishing them. Where are they? How are we going to survive? And if these people lose their jobs, if they park their taxis, if they park their trucks, if they park their two-wheelers and say that it's no longer viable, we can't do this anymore, our economy will shrink even further, because when a delivery person parks his motorcycle or sells the bike and says, I can't do it anymore, he's effectively lost his job. His family has effectively stopped earning. Same with a truck, same with a taxi. We can't afford to continue to cut the middle class at the knees. They're already hurting, and there is more pain in store, the pain that cannot be avoided at this point because of where we are economically. How can we be making it worse on purpose when we should be making it better? There has to be a kind ear from government, both state and center, to find ways to raise money that doesn't involve taking money out of the poorest pockets, that doesn't involve taking food and milk from the plates of smallest, poorest children in our country. We must be able to think up better solutions, and we have the minds, we have the experts, we have the advice. We're just not listening. And that's not a good enough reason to drive people into poverty, to drive people into unemployment, and to starve the children of our country. That's not a good reason. I'm sorry, that's not good enough. Take the advice. Do what you need to do. Apply balm on the pain of the poorest in our country. Don't make it worse. Don't put salt in their wounds. Thanks for watching. Good night.